let's talk a little bit about those conventions, Lisa. We've covered a lot of them in cycles past. This is going to look very, very different because of the pandemic, of course. So for our viewers, talk a little bit about what first the Democratic convention and then the Republican convention might look like now, knowing, of course, mm-hmm. that they are moving targets because a lot of changes are being made day by day.
Well, the Democratic convention is now less than a month away to begin the 18th of August. That's a change. It was originally going to be in July, but the pandemic, they pushed it back. And now we're seeing reporting today, and NewsHour has confirmed that the DNC is now moving to shorter evenings of convention activity, I guess you'd call it, or at a convention lineup, I believe from 9 to 11 each night, just 2 hours. A lot of that, we're told, if not all of it, could be just speeches brought in from remote sites that delegates will be voting and kind of doing that famous roll call from the great state of Missouri, you know, that roll call will be happening virtually and in locations all around the country. We are told that Biden himself will make remarks in Milwaukee. We're not sure exactly what that's going to look like. Right now, full disclosure, everyone, Dan and I, are scheduled to go to Milwaukee. We're hoping that we do go to Milwaukee. Of course, we'll be safe. But honestly, you know, everyone is having a difficult time planning because the parties are making such decisions so late in the game. And I'm going to leave it to you to talk about the Republican convention, which I think is perhaps even more question marks about that.
So the Republican convention, essentially like the Democratic convention, has been sort of the great shrinking convention in the last week or two. There was a period of time where President Trump, his campaign, was pushing aggressively to hold what would essentially have been a relatively normal convention in an inside arena with, you know, 20,000 or so delegates and other attendees over the course of many days. It was originally going to be North Carolina. That got changed after the Democratic governor said, no, we can't guarantee that you can do a regular convention with the restrictions we have in place for COVID. That was then moved to Florida. Now it looks like back to North Carolina. The lineup has been shrunk. It will probably now, like the DNC, be over just a couple of days. Just today, we know the Trump campaign rolled out a lineup, it appears, that is going to include sort of your regular mix of celebrities and musical acts who are going to be doing that via Zoom. So increasingly, we're seeing the RNC sort of pare down its overall schedule. Like in Milwaukee, we do expect to see President Trump deliver some sort of remarks, obviously, probably in front of a small audience, but it's going to be very pared down, Lisa, compared to years past. And I'm wondering, how do you think that impacts, you know, the message that both parties can get out? Normally, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of reporters there interviewing the delegates, sort of taking the pulse of the party. This year, with so much less going on, do either campaigns get that traditional sort of mini bump in the polls? Or is this going to be a situation where your average viewer will not be that involved or interested in what's going on?
I think time will tell. You know, you're right. These conventions are usually the ultimate adrenaline shot for either party. You know, those images of people on the floor holding those signs, sort of, you know, Democrats and Republicans gone wild with their sequin hats and their sort of like ridiculous ensembles that the American public kind of loves, that shows how charged up they are about their candidate. We may not see that in the same way. I think both parties will try with these satellite events to show that, to have that kind of enthusiasm. But if they have too much of a crowd, they will be dinged for not being safe. I think Democrats in particular are very, very concerned, and they've always been very aware and they're trying to follow the letter of the law, I think you could say, on COVID preparedness. Republicans have gone back and forth. Right now, President Trump, at least when he speaks from the White House, is starting to talk more like he is really dialed into following what the CDC recommendations are. We'll see what happens with the convention. I don't know. I have a feeling that the Democrats may get lucky in a way because this is so bizarre that people may tune in for at least the first night just to see what are they going to do. And then they have an opportunity. And if it's terrible, you know, if it's unwatchable, they may tune out for a couple of nights, tune back in for Biden's speech. you know, Trump always, I think he, when he speaks, he will get an audience. He's always going to get a huge audience, probably the biggest audience of the year in politics. But the rest of it is just very hard to say.